A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28th March, on the front page you have, successful anti-satellite missile test puts India in elite club. So this is regarding the test which India has conducted. Prime Minister has announced this launch in a televised address and he said it's for peace, not war mongering. So this is the satellite, anti-satellite missile test, ASAT, named Mission Shakti, which has been launched. So this has been successfully conducted. So India became the fourth country in the world to demonstrate the capability to shoot down satellites in orbit. So only US, China and Russia have this power, and now India becomes the fourth country. So this test which was conducted is a live satellite in low Earth orbit was shot down in space. So here you can see. So ASAT, this satellite, anti-satellite, is a modified interceptor missile of the ballistic missile defense system. So this, you can see the satellite was launched, the interceptor missile as such, left, and was a three-stage missile, and the kill vehicle is this satellite on top, around 300 kilometers, it's 274 kilometer height orbit, where the satellite MicroSat R was down. Then next you have, electoral bonds will affect transparency, Election Commission tells Supreme Court. So we have already been seeing about electoral bonds which have been introduced by the present government. So it says foreign corporates could influence Indian elections. So the Election Commission of India has submitted before the Supreme Court that electoral bonds, contrary to government claims, wreck transparency in political funding. So the cap on foreign funding has been removed by these electoral bonds. They invite foreign corporate powers to impact Indian politics. So we have already seen about the electoral bonds, you should know. So in this, it is said that who is donating to which political party will not be known, but there is no limit on how much you can donate. Earlier there was a limit which has been removed when electoral bonds were introduced. For companies there were limits, and for foreign funding also there is no such difference being made. So it's just an electoral bond which you can buy in as many number as you want, and you can give it to any political party which you want, and political parties are exempted from tax, so and they can take in unlimited funding. So this was what the electoral bonds brought, but then the government said that it will bring in transparency, though the Election Commission presently is saying that it is actually contrary to that. It will actually significantly impact transparency. The thing is that the government said it will bring transparency because the bonds would be brought through your bank accounts only. You cannot buy it with cash. So since there will be no cash donation which will be coming in as such, so then there is no need for, there is the money which is coming in is actually through bank accounts. So that's why it said that this is transparent mechanism. But then the Election Commission clearly points out that the amendments which have been made to various statutes through two consecutive finance acts of 2016 and 2017 to bring in electoral bonds, they will help in pumping in black money for political funding through shell companies and allow unchecked foreign funding of political parties in India. And politics in India will be influenced by foreign companies. And it said that amendments are virtually derailing the Election Commission of India guidelines of August 2014, in which it required parties to file reports on contributions received. But now these contributions from where is not to be known, so they will not file any such reports because of electoral bonds introduced. Then below you have Supreme Court for Then here you have Supreme Court for as few tribunals as possible. So Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi has said that numerous tribunals once meant to lighten the burden of high courts across the country have now become virtually non-functional, crippled by chronic lack of infrastructure, manpower and irregular appointment mechanism. So the Supreme Court, he says, practical solution is to have as few tribunals as possible. So tribunals, you should know, are quasi-judicial bodies which adjudicate on various cases. Then on page 7 you have anti-satellite weapons date back to Cold War era. So it was during the Cold War hostilities between US and Soviet Union that anti-satellite weapons were developed. But such tests have never been, you know, claimed credit for by countries when they shoot down their satellites for tests. But India has done so presently. It was through the Prime Minister's address to the nation that this anti-satellite test was announced. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is slow on sanitation. So this talks about policymakers, how they have failed to use technological advances made in treating fecal sludge. So we have seen recently also deaths due to septic tanks which have taken place. 6 deaths took place in Tamil Nadu. So this is editorial discussing the solutions to these and how India has not brought them into effect. And this is saving jet. So this is regarding Jet Airways. So it says, with the airline landing in the laps of banks, the challenge now is to quickly find a buyer. Then next, the lead article is the tragic heroes of anti-IS war. So this is regarding the Islamic State. It says, despite their historic role in destroying the Islamic State caliphate, the Kurds face risk of further aggression than recognition. So now the Islamic State has been destroyed, but then in Syria and in Turkey, the Kurds who want a separate identity for themselves, they are still struggling. And this is a blow against Article 370. So this is regarding special status of Jammu and Kashmir under Article 370 of the Constitution. It says presidential orders and the circumstances in which they were made have eroded Jammu and Kashmir's special status. So this is actually regarding the presidential orders which relate to reservation and promotion for scheduled castes, scheduled tribes in the state services and special provisions for advancement of economically weaker sections. So the 10% quota has also been brought in Jammu and Kashmir, and reservation for SCST has also been brought in. So this actually goes against the special status of Jammu and Kashmir. And this has been challenged before the Jammu and Kashmir High Court. On op-ed page you have, what we need is a common manifesto. So this is talking about how India handles land use change will decide whether it can improve lives without warming the world. So this is regarding climate change too, and how during the elections improvement of lives is, you know, put in the manifesto, but this one important issue has to be stressed on. And this is a deal at last. So this is regarding the Naga conflict. So the center's main interlocutor in Nagaland, the negotiator in Nagaland, R.N. Ravi, he is again visiting the state of Nagaland to find peace, to bring the earlier terrorist and separatist organizations like NSC and IM, etc. into the mainstream. So the peace agreements, peace deals have been finalized, framework agreement is in place. So this is whether there will be a deal at last and what we would see further. So we await that. Then on page 10 you have, parties can skip record of donations, says Election Commission. So the Election Commission, we have seen on the front page, submitting before the Supreme Court that how electoral bonds are going to go against electoral reforms. So this, again, it states that parties, because of electoral bonds, can skip having a record of donations. And they don't keep such a record, and there is no trail of where they got the money from. On international page you have, May to quit before next Brexit talks. So British Prime Minister Theresa May is going to quit before the next Brexit talks start. But it remains unclear even after this step, will the MPs back the government's deal? And this is, US House fails to override Trump's veto. So US President Donald Trump had announced national emergency to build a border wall between US and Mexico. So US House of Representatives actually failed to override
the veto power which President Trump had had in, you know in and to overturn this this emergency. Then below you have Pakistan acts to diffuse tension with Afghanistan. So Pakistan and Afghanistan have differences because of the same issue. So Afghanistan accuses Pakistan of supporting terrorism in its state. So now Pakistan is taking steps to diffuse tension with the Afghan government. And this is detailed coverage on Golan Heights, which has been in news. Israel had occupied Golan Heights, and recently US President Donald Trump endorsed it, saying that Golan Heights belong to Israel. And this is Pakistan MP moves bills on forced conversions. So this is Pakistani MP, that is Ramesh Kumar, who has sought enhanced punishment for those involved. And here below you have Thai opposition parties unite against junta. So seven party alliance claims to have a majority of parliamentary seats. So junta here means the military. So the parties have united against the junta. Then on business page you have India in pact to ease US firms compliance. So India and US have signed an intergovernmental agreement for automatic exchange of country by country, which is called CBC. So country by country reports would be automatically exchanged, and this will reduce the compliance burden of Indian subsidiary companies of US parent companies. So this is a very important step. It will make India compliant with BEPS project, that is Base Erosion and Profit Sharing project, of which India is an active participant. So what happens is, base erosion and profit shifting is about the parent company setting up its subsidiaries in other countries and shifting its profit, and that's how they avoid taxation. So there are provisions in place to make sure this does not happen, so that the parent companies, US firms, when they set up subsidiaries in India, they also need to get compliant with various norms. So this agreement actually provides for automatic exchange of this country by country reports filed by parent entities of MNEs, that is multinational enterprises. So this will ease US firms' compliance. Then this is Vedanta funds oil in Krishna Godavari Basin. So this is Vedanta Limited, which is Anil Agarwal led company. It has discovered oil in Krishna Godavari Basin on India's east coast. Then below you have Deposits Ordinance does not cover gold schemes. So this is regarding the center's recent ordinance banning unregulated monthly deposit schemes. That is banning of unregulated deposit scheme ordinance, which was promulgated by the president, so in February 2019. But then it is said that this does not cover gold schemes. So these are to save investors from losing money to Ponzi and fake schemes. And this does not apply to gold deposit schemes, you know, monthly schemes which are going on, like schemes operated by jewelers and also chit fund firms. So they would not be affected. Then on the last page you have Tipu Sultan's gun fetches 60,000 pounds at UK auction. So we have seen this in news, how India Pride project was trying to make sure that Tipu Sultan's artifacts are not sold. But the bidding took place, and it was stated that this gun was fetched, was collected from the battlefield. So that's the statement given. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com in the current affairs section, and here you can download the current affairs PDF, which is uploaded on a daily basis too, and you can access the news. Also, a detailed current affairs video is prepared, which you can access. So this is through the course, so you can enroll for the course, details of which are provided here. So that is it. Thank you.